Ostend, while it's warm, there's a nice cooling breeze. Seaside of Armour.
Even with the cooling wind, I think I'm going to need a cool bottle or two. And this will do for me. The old coffee bottle.
The music will get me a takedown.
Anyway, this is Betelbia. 7% brasserie.
I can't tell.
B. So. Hoppy.
Blow your head off, strong taste.
Yeah.
It's going to be tricky on the train going back. I forgot to say, I think B plus. Unbalanced, I think, is the technical term. I.e., hat off. The Wifi is free in here now. So, the piggy knife phone I can use photo transfer app to transfer some photos off. Sometimes, Steve. Anyway,
Diet Coke.
However, in the left hand one, Framboise Girardin. Girardin? 5%. Huge amount of fruit. Quite thin, quite acidic. The aroma is far stronger than the actual taste. I give it a B plus. Strange finish. So I've just spent the last 5 days getting photos off my iPhone. I have enough room for iTunes. Thank you, Copy Trans. But they're in the end. Anyway, this is D. Dolly Brewers. This is a triple. Lichtenfels Blonde. 9% alcohol by volume. Huge head. Now that tastes strong, but that's balanced. I'm going to give it a B++, because it is balanced and it is good. I love Goose. Goose Tilquin, slightly stronger at 6.4%. This is a 2014 edition. Ooh. Lovely aroma. Nice and bitter, nice and acidic. Quite gentle actually compared to Cantillons. I'm thinking B++. The alcohol doesn't really come through. Of Insta Old Brewing, 5.5%. Smells of old brewing. The straight in there would be the plus plus.
In the cool field, the pop of our bed, that's all
I'm saying.
We're smooth.
Yes. Jacobins. Rory Brockman, 5.5% alcohol by then.
And a sour.
A sour. Also.
Salamu alaikum.
Yeah,
B plus plus.